situations?
My father, was really on my ass. My father, I played sports. Mm. I played every sport you could think of. My pop made sure I played. I was really good at basketball, so my pop made sure that I really played basketball. I played basketball. I played AAU. I done traveled around the world playing basketball when I was younger.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, every trophy I ever got is an MVP trophy. Like, I was really good in basketball. But somehow, though, like, the streets just got to me, though, at an early age.
Really?
Yeah.
Why do you think that was?
Because
you were balancing selling drugs and basketball at one point?
No. I just gave it up.
Oh, okay.
I just gave it up. But not having the shit that I wanted, the shit I really wanted, though. Like, and I knew how I could get it, though, and that's just, you know what I mean?
Right.
Feel me?
But so did your parents, like, really try to rein you in when you were starting to get in trouble and shit, or were they powerless?
Yeah, that shit wasn't nothing that they could do. Like, that shit just was what it was. Yeah, that's just what it was. That's just what I was on.
Definitely. What was music always part of your life too?
Me rapping?
Nah, just like, was it the soundtrack to your childhood and shit? When you think about your childhood, what were you listening to?
As a kid, like, when Meek, I used to listen to Meek.
Mm-hmm.
Like, when Meek was really, like, coming up and all that shit, though, like, when he was younger as a kid, I listened to Meek. Everybody from Philly listened to Meek. But, like, when I start really, like, getting into my, something like into the music that I really, really like, my go-to would be Future Thug. Kodak. I'm tripping. Kodak, that's my favorite artist. Kodak is my favorite artist.
One of the goats.
Yeah, that's my dog, Kodak. Kodak, that's my favorite artist of all times, though.
Really? Wow.
Yeah, I don't think anybody better than Kodak.
Why would you say that?
Just what he talk about and everything about him, though. Like, he authentic, though. Mm-hmm. Like, ain't nothing, no cap. He ain't got no cap in him. Like, he ain't sugarcoating nothing. He a gangster.
He's like the ultimate dude who became this famous rapper and doesn't really seem like he's changed. If anything, he just kind of became like a more extreme version of what he already was.
Yeah, that's my dog. But Kodak, Future, Thug. And let me give you one more. But currently though, for the last couple years, I All Out Run.
Oh, really?
All Out Run.
You've been locked up the last few years too, right?
Yeah, that's really one of my favorite artists.
I interviewed him back in the day, yeah.
Yeah, All Out Run. And who else? One more.
Sosa.
Oh yeah, Chief Keef, of course. Sosa, yeah. Chief Keef. Yeah, of course, Sosa. Yeah.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Okay, but did you always think that maybe you were going to try rapping, or when did that become a thing?
No, I never thought I would have been a rapper, bro. Mm. You ever heard of Rico Havoc?
No.
Nah, he an artist, though, from Philadelphia, though. Like, he blew up, though, real fast, though. Like, after Meek and Uzi and all that, he was probably kind of like the next, though. He just fell off, though.
Mm.
He just, like, I'm not going to say he fell off, though. He just took a break and got too comfortable, though. And you know how the rap shit go. You know, everybody rapping, so it's always a substitution.
And it's hard to sustain being, like, a lit street rapper.
Yeah.
Like, some people can do it, but it's difficult.
Yeah, so that's like my brother. Like, we actually grew up together. I hung around when I was a kid. We actually grew up together. He's one of the biggest artists in Philly. And out of nowhere, I'm just like, man, let me just try to rap. Let me just give it a try. I went to the studio and made my first song. And the engineer that I was paying to record me, he was like, bro, I don't want your money, bro. I want you to finish making this song, bro.
Mm.
And he was like, bro, you don't got to pay me for no time. I was young, too. He's like, just make this song for me, bro. And I finished the song. It was a song called Dog Food, Skrilla Dog Food. That's probably one of my best songs I ever dropped ever in my life. Then that was my first song.
So from day one, rapping about heroin.
Yeah, that's where I come from, though, bro.
Right.
Like, that's all I know. That's where I come from. Like, I got dope tatted on my face, dog food tatted on my face.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, I got dog food tatted on my hand and everything.
Oh,
yeah, good. Dog food.
That's hard. But, I mean, that's kind of funny just because, like, you're so obviously authentically from that shit, but heroin and like selling coke and all this shit is like one of the most lied about things in the history of rap, right? Like, yeah. That's the one thing that so many rappers talk about, and you know that they never did it.
Yeah.
So it's kind of weird for you because it's like, it's so believable from you because I know what area you come from, and also like seeing the videos and how comfortable you are around all these smokers and shit. Yeah. It's just kind of like, what is that like to see this being something that so many people just like lie about?
I don't even know. I don't even pay attention to nobody else though, bro. I don't know. I don't even know how to answer for that shit though. I don't really pay attention to other artists. I don't really listen to other music for real, for real.
Mm.
Yeah.
Do you consider yourself a Philly drill rapper?
Hell no.
Drill's foreign. That's not what. But do you even talk about that shit when it comes to Philly, or is it you're just outside of it?
Yeah, what you saying? I'm outside of the drill rap shit.
Yeah, because like, that shit exists, but you don't consider yourself to be part of that.
No, I want to consider myself to be a part of it though, but I'm around it though. Like, I'm in it though. Like, I'm in the shit too. Like, I'm not. I just don't talk about it though. I'm in the shit and everything too though.